Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. You're joining me in the cockpit of the iniBuilds Airbus A350, and in this video we're going to look at the pushback and engine start procedure. Let's get going. So we're at the stage where the doors have just closed and we are ready to get underway. All passengers and cargo is on board. At this point we'd expect to receive a final load sheet, so we go for a process of just validating our data before we do anything else. So we want to cross check our zero fuel weight, so we can bring up the load sheet on the OIS, and we go to init, down to fuel and load, cross checking our zero fuel weight values, 1864, zero fuel weight center of gravity, 2968, 297, correct, and fuel 64. We want to check extra fuel here, so 3 tonnes, 34 minutes, that's still acceptable. Then we come across to the performance page, we check our trim, THS, that's the trimmable horizontal stabiliser for departure, 34.4%, and that matches the load sheet as well. Check the fuel on board, 64 tonnes, and the gross weight centre of gravity there, it's 30.4 and 34.4 there. That's all looking good. It's a good idea at this point to rerun takeoff figures, performance, especially if it's been some time since you've done it. Weather's very dynamic, as you know, and things change quite quickly. So resync weather and apply the Simbury profile to that. Make sure you're using the right air conditioning and config values, runway condition, that can obviously change. Recompute those values, send those over, so that's all accurate. Reconfirm those figures, bring up the best officer side as well, just validate that information across, make sure it matches. Flexing 55, V-speeds match, packs off, anti-ice off for this one. That's all looking sensible. Let's put that back on the flight plan page. So at this point we are ready for pushback. We can bring our taxi charts up on the OIS. We can also bring up the airport map on the navigation display. Improves our situational awareness on the ground. And we can adjust down and zoom in to a level we're happy with. So before we push, we just want to run a few checks. We want to ensure that ground power is disconnected, so we've got and removed, so there's no avail lights here on the external power. And we check the park brake is on, so we use the primary flight display for that. Then we'll come over, make sure our ground equipment and chocks are removed once we've got the park brake confirmed, and arm the slides. And then we verify that over here, so we have the slides now armed on all the doors. Then we want to make sure the beacon's turned on, and we want to come to our surveillance page. Go to default settings and confirm that, and that puts the transponder on in the correct mode for this stage of flight. And we also want to do that on the first officer side and confirm that over there, returning that screen to the flight plan page for departure. Good idea to verify your score code at that point as well. Then we want to bring up the checklist. So before start checklist, so gear pins and covers are removed. We've checked our fuel quantity. We make sure that is checked and balanced. We've used a little more on the left side due to the APU running. Happy with that. We've checked our takeoff data. ROREF is 1036 set, and that's 3 times. So first officer, captain, and SIS is 1036. Checked. Some of these have been auto-sensed, so the seat belts are in green and the ADIRs are in nav. That's been picked up by the system already. And we've now confirmed doors are closed, thrust levers have been sensed idle, and park brake is currently on as required. Beacon is on, checklist complete. And return that to the performance page for departure. And we want to face south on taxiway echo, so we can copy it to ground. We are clear to push. Facing south on echo. Clear to push. To communicate with ground crew, in the real world we would use the intercom switch here, and that's where we would speak Okay, we released the parking brake by request of the ground crew, and we confirm that on the PFE, parking brake released. So we're now pushing back. We have been cleared to start engines. However, we don't want to do that until we're away from stand. Once we're out of the boxed stand area, we'll begin our start. So we can start engine one now. So move down and we turn the ignition start switch to ignition start. We need to wait 10 seconds before starting the engine. Seconds elapsed. Move the engine master switch for engine one, so it's always engine one first. And we need to look for ignition within 40 seconds of fuel flow. So fuel flow's in, and we're looking for EGT rise within 40 seconds, which we have. The FADEX will deal with other issues such as hung starts, but that's one key thing we need to watch is the setting parking brake by request of ground crew. Want to confirm that on the PFD here, so parking brake set. Want to make sure the nose wheel steering disconnect message disappears once they remove the pin. That's engine one available, and we can now start engine two, and it's the same on the other side. We want to make sure that we have fuel flow and then EGT rise within 40 seconds. Fuel's going in, and we have EGT rise. Avail on engine 2, so that's a good start. Just looking for my ground crew person who should hopefully show me a pin. Oh, I think there she is. So once engine 2 is started, we want to make sure the engines are running idle for at least 30 seconds. So I've started the chrono again. I didn't see the wave from the ground crew, but they're walking away with a pin, so hopefully that's that check complete. So we'll then run the after start flow. So we've seen that the pin removed, but the engine mode selector comes back to norm in the middle position. Then we go to the overhead panel, we've got APU bleed off, anti-ice we'd either turn on or keep it off depending on the conditions and what we plan to use. Then we turn the APU off unless you're using the APU for departure. We'll check our ECAM status, no messages there. Then we come down and we'd arm the spoilers. So we've had a trim reset. We'll set our flaps, so we're config 1 on the flaps today. Check ECAM status, no messages. And then we check our trim, so we need to be within 1% either side of the magenta value there, so we've checked. That's 30.4, so we're 0.1 out, so that's fine. And then we look at the after start checklist. So it sensed that everything else other than anti-ice, which we need to confirm, is checked, as we don't require that today. And that's the after start checklist complete. We can now request taxi clearance from air traffic control. So that's the pushback and start procedure in the Airbus A350. If you have any questions on that, please drop them in the comments. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. Thanks for watching.